On March 25, 2014, WFO Norman will join the Impact Based Warnings experiment. This video will explain the experiment and show you how our warnings will be changing. The experiment began in the National Weather Service's Central Region, but this year is expanding to include other areas. The areas, shaded in purple, will be issuing impact-based warnings this spring. The Norman office will join our neighbors in Dodge City, Wichita, Tulsa, San Angelo, and Lubbock in the impact-based warning experiment beginning on March 25th. That's when you'll see changes appear in all of our severe thunderstorm and tornado warnings. We look at impact-based warnings as being an enhancement to our current warnings versus a major change, and we hope these enhancements will make our warnings more effective and easier to use. The special tags that appear at the very bottom of the warning should make it much easier for broadcasters and others to find the most important information and to help prioritize when you're dealing with multiple warnings. The enhanced wording in the impact-based warnings will give forecasters a way to express confidence in the potential impacts of a storm and detail the level of risk. We hope that impact-based warnings will allow us to make our warnings as effective as possible without making substantial changes to the existing structure, and that the words we use can help motivate people to take the proper precautions when they're threatened by a tornado or severe storm. As far as the Norman National Weather Service office is concerned, we want you to know that our warning philosophy will not be changing as the result of impact-based warnings. We will issue warnings for the same reasons we did before and do not plan to make any significant changes to how we operate during severe weather. We are also not changing our thresholds for issuing tornado or severe thunderstorm warnings. The Norman office is fairly conservative when it comes to tornado warnings, and we have no plans to change that. Just because we have different categories of tornado warnings does not mean we will issue more of them. In fact, you should not expect any change in the number of warnings we issue because of our involvement in the impact-based warnings experiment. The changes you'll see will be in the text of the warnings. Let's take a quick look at how our severe thunderstorm warnings will be changing. As you can see, the new impact-based warning looks very similar to the traditional warnings you're used to. The two main differences are the addition of three bullets in the middle of the warning. Those bullets describe the expected hazard, whether it's large hail, damaging winds, or both, the source of the warning, which could be either radar indication or storm spotter reports, and the expected impacts. This is the heart of the impact-based warning, where we describe the impacts that people in the warned area might see. The National Weather Service worked with social scientists to develop impact statements that were as short and descriptive as possible. This example is for a low-end severe storm, but storms with larger hail and stronger winds would include stronger wording about possible damage that could occur and protective actions people in the warning should take. At the very bottom of the warning, you'll notice what we call tags. This is the place where you will always be able to find the basic facts about the expected impacts, whether it's hail or wind. The changes to our tornado warnings are a bit more involved, so here's a brief summary of how they'll look. Impact-based warnings gives us three levels of tornado warnings with different wording and tags depending on what the forecaster thinks might happen. The lowest level of tornado warning, which we will call the base warning, will make up the vast majority of warnings we issue at the Norman office. The two tiers of warnings that deal with especially dangerous and damaging tornadoes will be used much less often. Next up, we'll discuss the individual warning levels. To give you some idea of the distribution of tornado warnings, we looked at every warning we issued from 2011 through 2013 and assigned them the appropriate level as if we had been issuing impact-based warnings at that time. You can see by the numbers that 92% of the tornado warnings during that three-year period would have been in the base or lowest category of tornado warning. The second tier of tornado warnings, which would be issued when a tornado is capable of causing considerable damage, came in at just over 6%. And the rarest of tornado warnings, reserved for those exceptional cases when a violent tornado is about to inflict catastrophic damage and potential large loss of life on a population center, made up only 1.4% of the total. Keep in mind that the 3 years we studied were very active years for tornadoes and tornado warnings. and we think the actual longer-term averages would be closer to 95% for the base warning, 4% for the considerable tag, and 1% for the catastrophic category of tornado warning. So let's look at each category, starting with the base level. This is the most common type of tornado warning and is most often issued when radar shows a potential tornado developing. It may also be used when spotters or other observers confirm a tornado, but that tornado does not pose an immediate threat to people or structures. Here's what the base tornado warning would look like. Just like with the severe thunderstorm warning, the main changes are the addition of the hazard, source, and impact bullets in the middle of the warning and the associated tags at the very bottom. If forecasters have credible evidence that a damaging tornado is actually occurring, they can use the considerable or PDS tornado warning. PDS stands for particularly dangerous situation and should not be confused with PDS tornado watches issued by the Storm Prediction Center. They have nothing to do with each other, so don't get confused. Here are a few recent tornadoes that would have fallen into the PDS tornado warning category, including strong and violent tornadoes around the Oklahoma City metro area from 2010 and 2011, the April 2012 tornado that moved through the middle of Norman, and the May 19th Kearney and Shawnee tornadoes from last year. The text of the PDS warning has a couple of new lines of text we didn't see in the severe thunderstorm warning or base tornado warning. First is a headline at the top indicating that this is a particularly dangerous situation. There's also a new tag at the bottom, the tornado damage threat tag. Remember, the tags will always be at the very bottom of the warning and will give you a very concise summary of what's expected. The final tornado warning type is the catastrophic or tornado emergency. This level of warning is exceptionally rare and is only used for the most intense and dangerous tornadoes impacting population centers. Since the phrase tornado emergency was first used by the Norman office on May 3rd of 99, we've only used it a handful of times, most recently during the May 2013 tornadoes. The list of tornadoes that would receive the catastrophic designation is very short and includes the Wichita Falls tornado from 1979, the violent Bridge Creek Moore tornado from May 3rd, 1999, the May 8th, 2003 Moore tornado, the May 20th, 2013 Newcastle, Oklahoma City Moore EF5 tornado, and the powerful May 31st, 2013 El Reno tornado as it approached the west side of the Oklahoma City metro area. Here's what the warning text would look like, and you'll notice the main difference between this warning and the previous examples we've looked at is the addition of the tornado emergency headline at the very top of the warning. Note the word catastrophic in the tornado damage threat tag at the very bottom of the text. All the changes you've seen in the warning text will also apply to severe weather statements, which are warning updates. You should always pay very close attention to severe weather statements. They're used to update the warning after it is issued, and they are just as important as the warning itself. In some situations, the severe weather statement will be used to change a tornado warning from base to considerable or catastrophic. So it's important to keep an eye on these very important messages. Now here's where you come in. We want to hear what you think about the new impact-based warnings. Go to weather.gov/impacts and click on Customer Survey to submit your comments and suggestions through the year. Your input can help make the impact-based warnings more effective, so let us know what you think. And thanks for watching.